Trucks, a fixture on Pakistan's highways. But this one has an unusual sight in the cab. Shami Makhtar may well be the country's only female lorry driver. Abandoned by her husband after the birth of their fifth child, she struggled in odd jobs for years. Despite learning to drive a car and opening a driving school, she found it hard to pay the bills, so she decided to get behind the wheel.
It doesn't meet all of my expenses, but even if it doesn't, one can't sit idle. If you need 10,000 rupees and get 7,000 rupees, it's a bit better than having nothing.
Women driving cars is not unusual in Pakistan. But like Shamin, others are pushing the social boundaries even further. Tayaba Tariq travels 25 kilometers to the Indian border every day for her job as a customs officer. A necessity made possible by her precious motorcycle.
It makes a person independent and responsible for themselves, especially girls. They don't remain dependent on others as they don't need to ask their brother or father to take them somewhere or pick them up.
But while the road offers independence, it also brings its own dangers. Women, no matter how they travel, often face abuse or harassment, especially in big cities like here in Lahore. For Zara Aslam, the solution was simple: rickshaws for women, driven by women.
We are trying to help women become entrepreneurs and operators and owners of their own rickshaws. So they're not working for anybody else. They will be their own boss.
We should be able to travel in dignity, whether we're walking on the street, whether we're on cycles, whether we need to take public transport.
According to the International Labour Organization, 3/4 of Pakistani women do not work because of a lack of safe transport. But with schemes like this one, and female drivers breaking taboos elsewhere, women are perhaps slowly but surely making Pakistan's roads their own.